Well, congratulations. Oh, look, there's John Bon Jovi now. John, how are you?
I'm really good. How are you?
I'm good. You two know each other, right?
Yep.
So I was just talking to Madonna a little bit about herself, but why don't you tell us a bit about yourself, too?
Well, I was born on March 2nd, 1962, and really wanted to be a rock star in my teens. Then, as most of you know, I created the band Bon Jovi.
Very interesting. What about you, Madonna?
I was born August 16, 1958, in Bay City, Michigan. I love singing, wearing cross necklaces, and bracelets, lots of bracelets.
Good. I love your bracelets, by the way. John, have you been working on any songs?
I have. It's called I'll Be There For You, but I just started it, so it might not come out for a while.
Well, I can't wait to hear it when it comes out. So while we're here, I wanted to talk a little bit about music for a while, and I wanted to talk about some world problems. What do you guys think about the Iran-Contra affair?
It was a huge scandal. Between the funding for the Contras and the weapon trade in Iran, it was just a dishonest affair.
Oh yes, the hostages needed to be brought back, but I don't really think it was the right way.
I even had a cousin that, my friend's cousin was one of the hostages. He was so devastated. Thankfully, he's back now.
That's sad, and happy.
Can you believe that the Berlin Wall came down? That was a huge landmark for Berliners.
Oh yes, that needed to happen. Thanks to the spokesman who let the Berliners cross the wall at midnight.
And it showed the world that the fall of communism, that communism was beginning to fall. Hopefully the Cold War will finally end now.
I know this is a little off topic, but what was the scariest moment of your life?
Probably the 1980 heat wave. I was in Texas at the time, and it was really scary. We needed the rain.
I could imagine. For me, it was probably the Challenger explosion. I knew Michael Smith, who was on the ship. I was so scared when I found out he had died. It was one of the worst days of my life.
That must have been really scary.
What was your favorite invention of the 80s?
Definitely the PC. Super radical.
I remember I used to work, we used to have huge computers that would take up like most of the room, but now you can have one that fits on your desk. It's truly amazing.
I know, right?
What is your favorite movie?
Well, I really like The Breakfast Club. Molly Ringwald's in it, and I think she's a really great actress.
My favorite movie is probably The Godfather. It's one of my all-time favorites.
Those are some good choices. I know the Breakfast Club is very relatable for young teenagers at the time it came out. What is your favorite book?
I really like Betty Friedan. She wrote the book It Changed My Life, which was a feminist book about women's rights.
I really like A Brief History of Time by Stephen Hawking. It explains a lot about complex objects such as black holes and complex math. I really learned a lot from it.
Those are some good choices. What's your favorite sport?
Definitely baseball. I know that the longest game of baseball ever played was on May 8th, 1984. My friends were talking about it, so I watched a little bit of the end. Apparently it was 8 hours long.
Oh yes, didn't the White Sox win against the Brewers?
Yes.
Well, I hate to stop this interview here, but it looks like we're out of time, so I'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Wubba, 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 good night, and God bless.